come in my stride.
Yes, sir, you may.
I have a decree. We are to tell the whole world about the amazing things that have just taken place. Officer, bring your ship to order.
First, the rules of order.
We must purge the meeting place of all undesirables.
Wait.
But, sir, it's against the law for the pig to be here.
We never invite the pig.
He's dirty and smelly.
Well, you hear about me every year. I'm an animal who has no fear. My sense of humor and my smile will get you through the toughest mile. My engine's got to get up and go, and I'm a building. The reason that I love to sing is that I'm the King's little singer. From Nazareth to Bethlehem, on my hat you can depend. I'm your driving dream machine. I'm the King's little singer. Back to the side and back saddlebags. No riding barely slack. I'm the coolest ride you see. I'm the King's little singer. I've got plus deluxe legacies and an open air conditioning. The power of the that can't be made. I get 7 miles to a sack of wheat from Nazareth to Bethlehem. On the high you can't be made. I'm your driving dream machine. I'm the King's limousine.
Okay, next. Campbells, let's hear your part of the story.
Hi, I'm Goldie.
Hi, I'm Randy.
And I'm Mer.
We carried the wise men, although sometimes we wondered how wise they were, like when they said they wanted to go follow the star to find the new king. They said, go saddle up, we're going to follow yonder star. You ever follow a star? It's very tricky. One cloudy night, the next day you're in Egypt.
And then they said, Herod wanted to worship in the new king. Yeah, right, King Herod wants to get rid of the baby king because he's jealous.
And he wanted us to trick all over the country to help. Right?
Anyway, it was a long journey. So to pass the time, we made up songs. That's when things were. new king.
No, the Messiah is going to save everyone from their sins and make this world make sense again. The king of all kings.
Interesting story, but hey, I've been investigating rumors about that new king for years.
Here I am.
his respect.
You're speaking up on the side, keeping all the edge.
You better not be lying. I take my authority very seriously. You depend on me for leadership. I have to check out any claims to the throne. I've been put in charge and I won't tolerate some imposter taking my place. If you find out anything else, I want to know about it immediately. I want a full report in my throne room of everything.
Yes, sir!
To the
came to tell us that the new king was being born. Come on, let's go find him.
Hey, he's just been born. I know where he is. Come on, I'll take you there.
Thank you.
thus.
Together we all rejoice.
Come on, let's go tell everybody the good news. The true King of Kings is here. Sing with us. Stand up.
Yeah. we will close our eyes and open them up right in the presence of the Lord. Isn't that wonderful, folks? Who will say no to this great gift? Who will say no? I can't imagine anybody saying no to such a wonderful gift. If I was to offer you $1 million right now, you would trample down this aisle to get it from me. But I'm offering you something even more than $1 million could never pay for. I'm offering what Jesus had offered a long time ago, and that's to receive Him as your Lord and Savior and have life everlasting, sins forgiven, and life everlasting. Amen. What this story is all about. Would you bow your heads just for a moment? I can't close this out without giving you an opportunity to respond. If you're here today and you believe what we've been talking about here, you believe that Jesus was born of a virgin. I can't explain it. These are miraculous things that have happened, folks. I can't explain them. But it's the truth. He lived a sinless life. How can this boy live a sinless life? Because not only was he 100% human, he was also 100% God. God was his father. Mary was his mother. And he was this innocent, sinless man who had done no wrong, committed no crime, who had been wrongly imprisoned, held in a trial that was in the dark, that should have never happened. But you see, it was the plan of God. And convicted him of crimes he did not commit. And they sent him off up that hill. You see, they all thought they were in control. Really, this was Jesus' purpose. It's why he was born. He was born to die. As he went up that hill, he had this on his mind. And they put him on that cross. And the blood was pouring down from the crown of thorns upon his head, from the spikes in his hands and in his feet. And from the lashes, from the whips, from the cat of nine tails that had ripped the flesh literally right off his body. The blood was pouring down. And with each drop of blood, there was your name. Your name written. Your name and the forgiveness of your sin. All you have to do is be on the bed. Also, Jesus died right there. They took him off the cross. They put him into a makeshift tomb real quickly. Hurriedly got him together for the burial. And they put him in that tomb, sealed it up before the Sabbath could take place. But you know something, on that Sunday morning, that third day on that Sunday morning, the stone was rolled away, the tomb was empty, and Jesus had risen from the dead. Risen from the dead, folks. So not only is he offering you forgiveness of sin, but he's offering you that same resurrection power in your life, where you will never die. All you got to do is say yes, you receive. All you got to do is say, I believe. This morning, if you've never put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ right now, this is the time of salvation. Right now, Jesus says this is your opportunity. So if you would like to receive Jesus and say yes to Him, right where you are with your heads bowed, eyes closed, no one looking around, would you stick your hand up right now and just say, preacher, that's me. I'm not going to call you down. I'm not going to ask you to come up here. I just want to know right now so we can pray right now. Would you just stick your hand up and say, yes, preacher, that's me. I've never trusted you, Jesus, but today I am. I want to live forever. I want to live for Jesus. I want my sins to be forgiven. I'm tired of waking up with shame and guilt in my head. Is that you? Put your hand up. Just put it up. You put it right back down. Slip it up. Slip it right back down. Amen. Father in heaven, I thank you, Lord, for decisions that are made all around. I thank you for these children presenting such a message to us from the mouths of babes. You see the lion laying on the ground. We'll give you the thanks and glory for all. You are so worthy of all of our praise. It's in Jesus' precious and holy name we pray. Everybody say amen. Amen, amen. Praise the Lord. I tell you how exciting that is. If you made a decision for the Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah. I tell you, this is the first day of you see me or one of our deacons here as we go out, I promise you they'll help you. They will help you. That's what they do. They're here to serve you. All right, listen.